And that raid is being felt personally by South Florida family of an American journalist who was beheaded by ISIS back in 2014.
This morning, the parents of Stephen Sotloff are sharing their feelings about this raid with CBS4's Ty Russell.
It's been very difficult for all of us, all the families.
It has been more than 5 years since journalist Stephen Sotloff was first kidnapped and then beheaded by ISIS. After all these years, his parents now feel a little closer to justice.
While the victory will not bring our beloved son Stephen back to us, it is a significant step in the campaign against ISIS.
President Trump announced Sunday the founder and leader of ISIS is dead. The feds blame Abubakar al-Baghdadi for the death of several Americans, including Sotloff.
The Sotloff family is thankful to President Trump, our brave U.S. Special Forces, and all involved intelligence allies.
Shirley and Art Sotloff live in Pinecrest in Miami-Dade. Since the brutal death of their 31-year-old son, they've turned their grief into action. And training from their foundation has already saved the life of a journalist covering a conflict-torn region.
He said that if it wasn't for the training that he received, that he wouldn't have been able to keep a clear mind. So this proves to us that what we're doing with the training is really something that's really much needed.
The Sotloff family started Two Lives Foundation to train journalists on first aid and safety, especially if captured and held hostage.
We know Stephen is looking down and he's very, very happy that we did something, because I know that we know that he would have wanted to make a difference.
These two parents also remain hopeful for Americans who are still being held as hostages.
We hope and pray that justice will be served with the two remaining hostages or prisoners.
The two parents are continuing to honor their son. On Sunday at the Dolphins game, two University of Miami students will be awarded with scholarships in honor of the fallen journalist. We are in downtown Miami. I'm Ty Russell, CBS4 This Morning.